Keyword allows the users to add new text to an already existing document. Place the cursor to the right of the character where you want to insert the text and then start typing. The existing text which is present after the cursor will be shifted to the right side. Now let us learn how to move the text. This feature is used to move the text from its original location to a new location. Select the text you want to move. Click on the Cut button in the Clipboard group on the Home tab or press Ctrl plus X. The text disappears from the document and is temporarily placed on the clipboard. Position the cursor at the location where you want to place the selected text. Click on the Paste button or press Ctrl plus V. The selected text appears at the desired location. Now let's learn how to copy the text. Copy and paste option are used to duplicate the text. We can copy the text not only from one location to another within a document but also from one document to another. This feature helps in reducing our time and effort in typing. The only difference between copy or paste and cut or paste features is that the copy feature copies the text but does not remove the text from its original place as the cut feature does. Select the text you want to copy. Click on the copy button in the clipboard group on the Home tab or press Ctrl plus C. A copy of the selected text is placed on the clipboard. Position the cursor at the desired place. Click on the Paste button in the clipboard group on the Home tab or press Ctrl plus V. The copied text appears at its new location in the document. Students, do you know the fact that clipboard is a temporary storage area in Windows that allows you to store, cut, copy and paste data while switching between the applications? Up to 24 multiple text and graphical items could stay on the Office clipboard until you exit Office applications. After exiting the Office applications, the last item that you copied stays back in the clipboard. Alright students, let us talk about deleting the text. Word provides the facility to erase the text. Follow these steps. Select the text. Press the delete key. The selected text will be removed. You can also delete text by using the backspace key. It removes the character to the left of the cursor position. To delete a block of the text, select the text and then press either the delete key or the backspace key. Students, press Ctrl plus delete and Ctrl plus backspace key combinations to delete one word to the right and one word to the left respectively. Students, let us understand how to use undo and redo commands. Microsoft Word keeps track of all the changes that we make in a document. We can easily undo any change and restore the original text. Undo. Undo option reverses the effect of the last command. To reverse one or more than one action, click on the Undo button present on the Quick Access toolbar. Redo. Reverse the action of the undo command. Click on the redo button present on the quick access toolbar. Students, note that the shortcut keys Ctrl plus Z for undo and Ctrl plus Y for redo commands are respectively. Now let us talk about checking spelling and grammar. Word has a built-in dictionary and a set of grammatical rules to check the spellings and grammar of the text document. Incorrectly spelled words are displayed with a single red wavy line under them. The grammatical errors are indicated with a green wavy line. The spell check starts from the position of the cursor and checks the complete document. A simple method to check the spelling of any word is as follows. Right-click on the word with a red wavy line. A shortcut menu opens, displaying various suggestions. Select the correct spelling from the suggestions list. Microsoft Word automatically replaces the incorrect spelling with the selected option. Students, note that the shortcut key to check spellings and grammar is F7 key. Students, we can also click on Spelling and Grammar button in the Proofing group on the Review tab to correct the spellings and grammar in the document. The Spelling and Grammar dialog box appears with the wrong spelling highlighted in red along with a list of suggestions. Students, let us talk about using Thesaurus. Thesaurus helps to improve our vocabulary by providing a list of synonyms, words with similar meaning, and antonyms, words with opposite meaning for any word. Follow these steps to use Thesaurus. Select the word for which you want to find synonyms or antonyms. Click on the Review tab. Select the Thesaurus option in the Proofing group. The Research task pane opens, displaying the synonyms and the antonyms. Move the mouse pointer to the suitable word. Click on the drop-down button and select the Insert option. The existing word will be replaced with the new one. Let us quickly glance through the key points discussed in this chapter. Word application opens a blank document with the temporary name Document 1. Making changes in a document is called editing. To perform any action like copying, moving, finding, replacing, deleting, or formatting the text, we need to select the text first. Incorrectly spelled words are indicated with a red wavy line under them. Grammatical errors are indicated with a green wavy line.